Vijay, sorry to interject, but why don't you talk a little bit about the historical aspect of Badyar and how the people in Badyar were kind of thought of being, they were pretty talented and certain type of people that lived in that area.
That's correct. That's correct, Kuldeep ji. See, I don't know whether it was by default or by design, Badyar and its adjoining areas. There is one section in my book. I have divided my book into four parts. So, one section is the development of art in Kashmir. After I am done with that, how the art developed, the origin, I have just traced back its route to the times of Nilmat Purana, 6th century. It's a 6th century treatise on the art and culture of Kashmir. And the art in Kashmir is as old as Kashmir itself. So then I come to the essence of Badyar. The Badyar and its adjoining areas, you name it, has produced luminaries and gems. Then I was told by one Mr. C.L. Hakku, he was with Doordarshan and I think he retired as Deputy Director General. He was in Jalandhar also. This year only he passed away. He told me that Maharaja, he just wanted that the people who are involved in art, culture, languages, who have some kind of scholarship, they were settled in Badyar up to Purshiyar. Even you can go up to maybe almost up to Mara. हबकदल के भी आगे इधर पुरशियार जा सकते हैं, बड़ियार से शुरू कीजिए, बड़ियार से यू स्टार्ट अप टू पुरशियार, यू नेम परफॉर्मिंग आर्ट्स, विजुअल आर्ट्स, लिटरेचर, यू नेम इट, जस्ट रैंडम आप सोचो, ही विल बी फ्रॉम दैट एरिया, वेदर इट इज मारा थिएटर ताचोस, मारा कला कला केंद्र खुले गौर देती बड़िया रही तत उस मारा ड्रामा, तत उस मारा पथ संगीत नाटक खुले होते थी बढ़िया रे खुले हो, तत मारा उस मारा सतलाल कंपासी, तत मारा उस मखनलाल सराफ, तत मारा उस गुलाम रसूल संतोष, तत मारा उस त्रिलोक कोल, तत मारा उस अवर फैमिली, तत मारा उस सोमनाथ भट्ट, तत मारा उस शुभन काव, तत मारा उस दीनानाथ वली, तत मारा उस संसार चंद वली, तत मारा उस यू नेम Tatmaros Ratan Parimu, he was dean in the MS College, Baroda, or you name it, Tatmaros Bansi Nirdosh, Tatmaros Chamanlal Hakku, you name any random, you say, you Mara Suchuteti, you will find it from Badyar. So the essence of Badyar, not only because of the Ganesh temple, it has also a history. I have mentioned that also in the book, how the idol was thrown into the, by Pathans into the river Jhelum, how it was retrieved later on, what sanctity it has got, Sanctum Sanctorum, Kya Shutaju Ganpati Aruk, that aside, religious, but the scholarship of the people. It has produced gems, Badyar. Acha Mara, star maestro, Krishan Longu is from that place. Pandit Omkarnath Raina, star maestro, my uncle, he is from Badyar. And Badyar, Maharaj, Bikya one of the. It is a, like a abode of Goddess Saraswati there. Talented, it's throbbing with talent, throbbing with scholarship. Badyar Bala. It is all mentioned in my book. Then he told me that it was by design. It is not coincidence. Those people were made to settle. We also ran us. It's 300-year-old family, their history, which I have been able to trace. We used to live in, I was told that Raghunath Mandir. Raghunath Mandir, then we were, shifted to Badyar Bala. Then he told me, if you see the downtown, there you will find traders, the wholesalers. They were settled there. If you see the expats, like there are some Jews, there are Turks, Kashmir is an admixture of so many races. Kashmiri Pandits. Now it is also debatable. Some say there's pure Aryan race. Some say no, it's admixture, Kashmiri Pandits. So the expats, like Jews and all that, they were settled around Nigin Lake and all that. So there is a history. So you will find the scholarship. Badyar throbbing with the talent, scholarship, all literary people, all luminaries. The other day I was just asked, discussing just casual, it was a chit chat with this Muhammad Yusuf Teng. He is a director general, retired culture, director general culture. He told me that it was like he named that Aflatun, the plateau. I think plateau is known as Aflatun in Urdu or Farsi. So he said Badiyar was like a university in itself. This is Mohammed Yusuf Teng telling me. He's a retired director general. He said it was a small university. When once you would be in Badiyar, it would be very difficult to decide whom to visit first, which house to go to first. So every place, everywhere, a small university like that of, he has given me some comparison with Aflatoons, he told me that plateaus. Then I deciphered it. I saw with Google what does it mean. Then I have deciphered in that in my book. So this is the people who have visited that place, even though he's not from Badiyar. So similarly, Ghulam Nabi Khayal was PTV correspondent also long time. He lives in Rawalpula in Srinagar. He says, ki Badiyar, once you would be in Badiyar, and it would be a different feeling altogether, a different aura. So that was Kuldeep ji. Now the times are changed. That was the time. So when Badiyar used to be throbbing with the Calliope, this KB Razan sir says, ki, like the akin to our goddess of learning, goddess Calliope in Greek mythology. It was like that, Badiyar.
Sudhirji, you mentioned the title of your book, Art in Kashmir and Mohan Raina, The Creative Genius. Can you be very specific about why do you call him a creative genius?
Yes, because actually the real recognition Mohan Raina got was in 1950 when he joined the Department of Information after Textbook Advisory Board. As Anil ji was mentioning, his first job was in Textbook Advisory Board, because there, the mastery on the figurative work was required, because one had to illustrate the textbooks and all that. So 1950. So then that time, the then Prime Minister of J&K, Sheikh Mohammed Abdullah, then when they met, and a need of the state emblem was felt, that their Kashmir J&K should be given some identity. It should have its emblem. It should have its identity. So then the task was given to various people, different agencies, private, government. So was it given to the Department of Information. That time, the Director of Information was Shri J.N. Zutshi. He was later elevated to the post of Director General, Information. He had a lot of, confidence in Mohan Raina, his drawing prowess, his perfection in figurative work, because my father didn't believe much in distortion. He did abstract, but he said that first you should learn how to draw a straight line and then attempt breaking it. Smudging of paint is no modern art, is no art. So he was very, very, very strong on figurative work. You see, that time there are so many people like Padma Shri Rajinder Tikku and others who have told me, Trilokol, that time making an emblem without the computer-aided designing, which is now available, it is not a small thing. You have to have perfection in drawing. So this job came to the Department of Information also. J.N. Zutshi very promptly handed it over to Mohan Raina. He told Mohan Raina, this is your baby. So Mohan Raina conceptualized, designed this emblem of J&K state, which is still the identity of J&K. Even now, it was designed, it was conceptualized in 1952. So then when all the designs went to Sheikh Mohammed Abdullah, then he said, yes, the interpretation given by the artist was three horizontal lines depicting the three regions, Jammu, Kashmir, and Ladakh. The plough is the population. The majority is agriculture, kisan. The air, these corns, is the agriculture we are dependent on. The water, the purity, and the lotus is the knowledge, is the purity. And down below Jammu and Kashmir, inscription is the legend down below it. So he then passed on the resolution. He said that I am pleased to approve this emblem for J&K state. So this is creativity. He just conceptualized, he designed, is a creation. Then again, in 1958, Republic Day celebrations in New Delhi, he is a man who conceptualized, designed, and executed the tableau Winter in Kashmir. I was also there on that janki, on that tableau. as a young boy, I was staying there as a Kashmiri, and my uncle with that attire of a Kashmiri farmer, he was also there. For the first time, J&K has won first prize amongst all the participating states of India.
That is truly amazing. So I think this was very interesting. You explained this emblem, and we have a collection of some of the paintings of Mohan Rayanaji. We also have heard the story of how you retrieved those payments and those paintings, and we'll get into that.
Yeah.
But let's go over some of these paintings and ask you questions, because every painting has a context. You give us the context and the background of the design of the emblem and what it signifies. And how
again, sorry, I'm interrupting you, Arunji, because you asked me the question creative. See, you name it in 50s to 70s, there is hardly any emblem, monogram or logo which has not been conceptualized by Mohan Raina and designed. Later on, some were changed due to political reasons or other reasons, like medical college. There was only one medical college in Kashmir. The original logo was given by Mohan Raina. Then there were two medical colleges. It was changed. Now it is very crude. But the present artist has borrowed the elements from Mohan Raina's original emblem. He had shown that caduceus with two serpents, which is a symbol of medicine in Greek mythology, and that staff, which is a symbol of surgery. Then you come to Regional Engineering College. The logo was given by, the emblem was given by Mohan Raina. Then you come to Kashmir University. The emblem was given by Mohan Raina. Then even now, Sheri Kashmir Institute of Medical Sciences, the logo is given by Mohan Raina. Even present logo of SP College, the logo is given by Mohan Raina. Academy of Art Culture, the original logo is given by, you name it. He has done it. Creative.
That's an amazing answer, Sudeji, and that's exactly what we were looking for. So what you're saying here is that you call him a creative genius because he wasn't trying to follow a form, but he was looking at originality. So all these emblems, they had to be contextual. Say, for example, if it's a medical college, then it has to be related to something in medicine.
Exactly.
J&K, it has to be about J&K, symbolize that. So he would put those thoughts together, whatever he wanted to symbolize. And without the aid of modern technology, AutoCAD, Photoshop, he was able to create art, which was very symbolic and very representative of whatever he was trying to project. That is very, very clear. And I think just on the topic of emblem, we were able to get very useful information. We want to go over some other paintings with you of his.
Yeah. And then I will tell you some anecdotes in the making of an emblem.
Sudeji, but we would like to go through these paintings. And please tell us the background of this one and also the technique used. You said oil on board. Please explain to us what were the different forms of doing art in Kashmir at that point in time. There are some pencil sketches, there's some oil on board. How did he make those emblems, for example? What was his painting style? So please walk us through that.
Yes, there are about 50, 60 paintings of Mohan Raina in the book, but I have selected a few. See, there are, Mohan Raina was very versatile in the sense that he would do oil color, he would do watercolor, he would do painting with knife, he would do paintings with rollers, he would do painting with sable brushes, he would do painting on canvas, he would do painting on board, and then he would do different, he didn't follow any particular genre. He was doing abstract, he was doing, but he believed in naturalistic, natural, the landscape. He would believe in that perfection of art, perfection of drawing, perfection of figurative work. But as I told you in the beginning of our interaction, I told you I didn't have even a single painting of my father. We'll come to that later on. But he was very lavish in obliging his friends. Whatever I have been able to retrieve, it is because those are scattered. Some are with the galleries, some are with the Lalit Kala Academy, some are with the private collectors, some are abroad. So some people have sent me through maybe mobile cameras, whatever they could. So they might have lost their pristine glory because some paintings are as old as 1949. But also I have thanked those connoisseurs of art who have preserved the works of my father so meticulously, and I have been able to showcase those. Now, for this painting, this is oil on board. Now, when we talk about oil painting, oil is a medium. So you can't mix water with it. Of course, as the name implies, oil painting. So you have to use varnish and turpentine and all that. Either you can, the surface has to be either board. You see, we call it plywood. This one side is like grains, other side is like smooth surface, which we call as hard board also. Is a thick board of different strengths. One is like a grains. It is like grain, and other is smooth. So the grainy portion, grainy surface is taken. Primer is applied so that it doesn't absorb much paint. So primer is applied. Then oil painting is done on it. Watercolor cannot be done on board. Only oil painting can be done. So now then the painting is done on the board. We call it oil. That is oil painting, of course, on board. Second, oil you can do on canvas, which is a thick cloth. It is to be mounted on the frame, stretch it properly, then paint on it, mount it on easel, whatever is comfortable, paint it, then you do the proper framing. Again, watercolor too cannot be done on canvas. You have to do oil. Now, oil painting, you do either with brushes, flat brushes, sable brushes, or you do with knife. That painting will come later on. I will show you that painting is just with knife, no brush used in that, just with knife strokes. There is a special knife. It has a flexible blade with a handle, wooden handle, and
Let's move to the next painting then, because you're already going to the fifth or sixth. So let's focus on this one.
Yeah, this is by Pandit Naranju, Mohan Rana's grandfather. It is 1890s or 80s painting. This is ink on paper. Is written in Urdu, Az Dast Naranju. Az Dast Naranju means by the hand of Naranju. Now, this painting has been interpreted differently by different people. One of my friends, good friends, Rakesh Kohl, he's in New Jersey. He has interpreted it like that it looks like a kundalini, that this serpentine is this circle. But I don't know, different people interpret it differently because the artist is no more. It's very old painting. So it was, I just got hold of it when I was doing the research work. I was going through the length and breadth of whatever places I could go. I chanced upon a couple of paintings, and it is not in its proper order. And this is one which has been done by Naranju, Mohan Rana's grandfather, who was a miniature painter. Much later, he went to Kangra to learn the intricacies of the miniature painting. So those are while destroyed. We'll come to later the forced exodus and all that. This is in 1958, during, as I was telling you, when J&K won first prize for the first time. Then Pandit Nehru was the prime minister at that time. Pandit Nehru used to visit personally where my father used to stay, along with his father, my grandfather, who is in Achkan and Muffler, Pandit Shivnath Rana. So there used to be so many one-on-one, which later on was told to me by my uncle, who was also accompanying, because I was a young boy. I don't know. I have no memories. And then my dad's personal photographer, Hari Mohan Datta. He was a Datta photographer. He's no more. Peace be upon him. And Rugunath Mandir, he was a good friend of my dad. Dad has taken his personal photographer with him. It was a collection of about 50, 60 photographs, one-on-one. With Dr. Rajinder Prasad sitting on the chair saying namaskar, dad half bent. Because then we were invited, as I am told by my elders and my uncle, for lunch by Pandit ji. Then dinner was Rajinder Prasad Rashtrapati Bhavan. So that time was all full of parties and all that, because it was something for the first time that this first prize and J&K got the recognition. This is my dad shaking hands with Jawaharlal Nehru and my grandfather in muffler. This painting.
So I...